Are we live? Hopefully we're live. I'm gonna start our stream over here at the train station. Lots of folks here today. Hi everybody, hi Mandy. See you were on the stream before we even got here. Oh, Christopher is watching. Hi. I'm glad the picture looks good. Sound is good. Let's see if that continues as we make our way through the park. Oh, look at that. We have Goofy making his way. Hi, Lori Jean, how are you? Thank you for joining us on our live stream today. We are gonna make our way down the steps. We're gonna go check out Goofy. Maybe have some character interactions. Let's go check him out. We have Goofy down here and right by the flagpole, and then way over here, we have Mickey Mouse. Let's go check him out. Oh, tomorrow is Goofy's 90th birthday. What? I guess we should go say happy birthday to him. Happy early birthday. 90. Wow. He looks amazing. I'm going to ask him what kind of night cream he uses. I know. He looks fab. Well, he is part of the Fab Five, right? So he should look fabulous. Chris, it would look better if you were shooting the video. Maybe, but you're not here. You know what? Let's go check out Goofy. There's already quite the line forming for him. Maybe they know it's his birthday tomorrow too. It is crowded today. I took a little glance around the park earlier before our live stream, and yeah, it was busy. Oh, look at him.
All right, now you want some cheese? This one?
Yeah. I love these character interactions. There's a whole lot of hugging going on. It's a love fest now.
Let's get out of the way over here. Come on, buddy. Oh, watch out.
Hi.
Sorry.
It's okay. Oh, it's a love fest. Oh, there, fist bump. Oh, poosh. Oh, look at how long the line's gotten already. I'm like, maybe I could sneak in. Well, I don't know. It's going to take a long time. But let's go check out Mickey. Mickey's on the livery stable area. I know, I'd be hugging Goofy too, Emily. But the line is so long. Free hugs. Free love. Free hugs.
Get out of here.
Let's go check out Mickey Mouse. He's over here at the livery station. He was out earlier, and then the line was like maybe 4 or 5 people, and I thought, oh, maybe I could go over there and get in line and open the live that way, but then he left. It never fails. Never fails. Whenever I want to go meet with a character, they take off. Yeah, this line has grown rather large too. Yeah. Well, gonna have to give him a hug sometime, some other time. Oh. Oh, and he's signing autographs. Hugs all around. Oh, and he kissed it. Too cute. Yeah, but look at the line. The line is like, woof, crazy. It is crazy long. People will wait for character interactions for a long time. I would love to hug them, but I gotta keep moving. Who's this? Can't read your mind. The sun. The Josh Sings. Hi, Josh. Hi, Josh Sings. Thank you for joining our live today. We are making our way just around the park. Now, I'll tell you, there's a reason really why we came today. We had gotten some, there's some rumors flying around about things opening.
Get on this area, it's too
fantasmic. Maybe a soft opening. Yeah, I walked over there earlier today, and if they were doing a soft opening, there would be carts with poles and like rope and stanchions, and there's none of that. So there will be no soft opening today. It was just a rumor. Would have been nice. But yeah. Look at all these people, my goodness. Everybody's waiting for the electrical parade. I feel like I'm zoomed in. I guess that's better. Oh, duck. Dodge the duck. Yeah, it is really packed here today. And it's hot. It was a warm afternoon for sure. Yeah, I'm solo today. Hi, Frankie's Bride. I am here all by myself. Chris is doing the travel, business travel. So it's just me getting in my steps. Actually, I was curious to see if Fantasmic was actually going to do a soft open. You never know with Disney, they do these things by surprise, but no, the only one who's surprised are the people who thought it was going to happen today. Yes, Chris is watching from afar. Oh, I love this. Mickey and Walt with his castle.
Hang on, I was going to tell you. And then I booked him the
I love it. So, Lori Jean, where are you? You said you missed Disneyland. Where are you? With the Orbitron. Oh my goodness. Yeah, we are blessed. We live so close to the park. The only thing that we can't guarantee are a reservation every day. I know. He's holding his hand. Closer look at the beautiful castle. It's not yet the golden hour, but it's getting close. Oh. Yes, it is very special. Northern California, 8 hours away from Disneyland. Yeah, that's a trek. So when you come visit, I'm guessing it's not a single day. I don't know if I could make the drive all the way to, let's see, what is our castle, right? Yeah. No, Chris, it's not possible for a soft opening. I did my due diligence and triple checked, and I got word that there is no soft opening tonight. Yeah, but there may be something, not necessarily for park guests, but for cast members coming up later on this week. So, and there's still no information on how this queue is gonna work. There's no virtual queue, boarding groups. Everybody's still kind of trying to figure out how that's gonna go down. I know, boo. Yeah, I'm trying to think of when we drive somewhere that's 3 hours, like Vegas. I don't think we've ever done like a turnaround. Like, you leave in the morning and you come back at night. Let's go check out Tomorrowland. See what's happening over here. It is just as crowded as the rest of the park. I'm looking for some place that might not be so crowded. Our castle's the oldest. All the others, castles, right? Yes, ours is the original. Well, if you think about where Cinderella's castle came from, is it Castle Weinstein? It was modeled after a castle in Germany, I think? Yeah. And it does look very much like it. Let's check out the standby time. It's 20 minutes for star tours. So not horrible. I've seen it a lot worse. 20 minutes, we could do 20 minutes, easy.
Where's the lightning lane?
Got Astro Blasters over here, 65 minutes. I know, the people mover, I wish. If we were at, Disney World, it's so funny, it's not like an e-ticket ride, but it is when it comes to nostalgia. Everybody's like, oh, the people mover. Hi, Timothy, how are you? Yeah, there you go. I can't pronounce it. All I know is it's Weinstein. Here we go, Astro Blaster, 65 minutes is a wait time. This is a fun ride. If you can make sure that your gun works, a lot of the time it doesn't work. I like to beat Chris on that ride. Let's go over here. What I wish was that they still had the Skyway. Oh, yeah. My goodness. Ooh-wee. Yeah, they really need to pump this area up. Although, even though there's not a lot going on, you have Hyperspace Mountain now, which will turn back to Space Mountain.
What's that?
Shortly, Star Tours, Astro Blasters, Orbiter. There's really not all that much going on here, but it gets packed. The Star Trader. The OG. Walt Disney World was coming back. Let's take a look at some of the.
But I only slept an hour.
C-3PO and R2. His little light is on. Let's keep it moving. Let's go this way. So many people. My favorite Star Wars character is C-3PO. Oh! Well, let's take another look. Let's take another look for you. Let's get a good head to toe. He looks really good, too. He's even got the little wires coming out of his stomach. I wonder how heavy this thing is. Is it just like a complete plastic shell and we could twirl it if we wanted to? Or is it really heavy?
What did he tell you that he was doing that?
Walt Disney World Railroad have a new track layout already. Thank you, Chris, for answering questions. For whatever reason, my chat doesn't stay up. Let's go take a look at Space Mountain. Hyperspace Mountain for right now. See it from here. I think the light is. I think the light is being.
So.
Yeah, there's nothing being displayed. I'm sure it's very busy though. That's if we get closer, if we can see. There's a lot of people coming out. That's not a good sign. More people coming out than there are going in. Is it down? Yep, it looks like it is down. Hyperspace Mountain is down for the count right now. No ETA. Wow. No ETA, and they're asking everyone to leave the area. Chris is modding right now, and he's 3 hours ahead. Anthony Daniels, yes, he played C-3PO. Timothy, you rode the People Mover many times at Disneyland since the 60s. Yeah, we need to bring something back. Although, I can't imagine what it would take to get that back moving. I mean, some of these things that we had closed for just a couple of years, they can't get working after the pandemic. Fantasmic is having a horrible time getting back up, from what I hear. Even though it's scheduled to come back on the 28th, they're still having issues. So up above, oh, it looks like not all the tables are up. So this is a Skyline Lounge, and it looks like there's a whole bunch of tables missing. Are they not, well, there's only three tables set up right now. is today not a day that they're having those? Oh, here's a little bit. There's a few more, but there's a big gap. There's a big gap right here. Don't know what's happening with the Skyline Lounge. I thought it was every day kind of a thing. Well, I guess on the weekdays, there are no fireworks. It's just projections. So, okay, that makes sense. Let's go see what Autopia has got going on. It always smells like gas over here. The fumes are strong with this one. Yes. Looks like it's a 30-minute wait time. Not horrible.
Shower.
Oh, it just, wow. That just, within seconds, it went from 30 minutes to 60 minutes. 60 minutes now. You blink and things change. Take a look at some of these Mickey ears. Yep. I like the donut ones. Makes me hungry though. What else do we have over here? Oh, they have the picnic ears. These ones are so cute. All kinds of ears. And I did hear that the Scarlet Witch ones were back. They are back in stock. I don't know if they're still in stock, but they're across the way at DCA. Across the way at DCA, the Collector's Warehouse, from what I heard. Who's walking into the sun?
Good idea.
Let's walk around this way. Here we have Nemo, still not open. Yeah, I don't know if climbing into a tiny little sub is something that people are gonna look forward to moving forward. Yeah. Still unavailable, still under renovation, but it is filled with water, so that's a good thing. Let's go around this way. Oh. All the little characters. So cute. And here we have Crush. What they should do is replace this with Crush's coaster. Yeah. Still got some time to set up. Yeah, it is coming back soon, but not soon enough. These crowds, they don't have enough to do, so getting the rides and the shows back up as soon as they can. I'm looking forward to what they updated. Oop, I'm way behind. Hi Trish, how are you? Yep, let's keep it going. Yeah, they should put Crush's Coaster here. Crush's Coaster was a lot of fun. So hope everyone is having a good evening. Tim, when I was a kid, I was scared of the shrinking machine. I thought it was really shrinking my dad, laughing at me. Don't we all shrink though when we get older? I think that's just a something that happens. Woo. The Matterhorn is up and running, and I can hear screaming from inside the tunnel. You can probably hear it too. It's so loud. And here's the line. Yeah. Can't get away from the lines, right? No matter where you go. Let's check out the Genie Plus lines. Are they giving any relief? If you really want to jump on a ride and not have to pay the $20 for the service, let's check it out. Yes, Chris does not like the Matterhorn. The last time Chris went on this ride, he had bruises on both sides of each of his knees. He got banged around on that ride really bad. That's a lot of folks, and it's not a fast floating ride either. Oh, adventures through inner space, yes! Look at this. So we have the Matterhorn here, and if you want to ride on it, it is 65 minutes. They do have a lightning lane, so if you are a Genie Plus purchaser, the line is not bad. The line is not bad. So it does save you some time, at least with this particular ride. That ride just tossed you around. It does, but you kind of have to. You kind of have to brace yourself. Brace yourself the entire way, and then like a motorcycle, right? Whenever it moves, you move. But then sometimes it throws you like this jolt, and then you didn't know what's coming. Oh, the balloons. Are these the lighted ones? I don't think they have the lights on.
It's got Tiny World on it.
Look at these. So cute. And they have these ones over here. A Chip and Dale, and then they look like they're babies. Lori Jean Matterhorn Bob says is a little scary. Yeah, it's and the fact that it's made out of wood and there's water running through it and they have to replace a lot of stuff. Yeah, it is a scary ride. Chris has been in the middle of that thing, and I have to practically beg him to get on it, because it's not a ride that he'll willingly get on unless I say please with my little puppy dog eyes. They need to start from scratch. Yeah. And make it all metal. Small World never has a long line. Unless it's during the holidays. I think it says it's about 20 minutes. I rode the Skyway through the Matterhorn a very long time ago. Yes! I did too as a kid, and now we have nothing. I have yet to get a balloon, like the newer styled balloons. The ones that don't pop, they like leak. Yep, it's 20 minutes, not so horrible. I don't know if the connectivity would be all that great in there. There's the train in the back. I thought about maybe riding the train. As long as the picture quality is still okay. So over here, with Toontown being closed, we have the Fantasy Theater. Fantasy Theater coming back up on the 28th.
Bye, sweetie. Good times.
This Saturday, not only for Fantasmic is going to be crazy, but it's going to be crazy for Fantasyland Theater too. There is the Lion King show coming. I think the first show starts at noon. Let's go take a look. They've opened it up. So they don't have anything. It says now showing and there's nothing. But there will be a Lion King show here on Saturday, on the 28th. So Chris and I were here way back when they had the Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs show. It was the premiere, the grand opening. They had all the stars here. It was pretty cool. Yeah, let's see. Looks like there's some stage work being done. Let's see if I can zoom in. If you can see them, they're painting, adding some finishing touches. This guy right here. Oh, Trisha. Thank you. Oh my gosh, every time I see one of these yellow things, I'm like, what? What is that? Thank you so much. We appreciate your support to the channel, your continued support, even if you don't send a super chat. You don't have to send a super chat, Trish. Just your support, watching, letting us know that you appreciate what we're doing. Hitting that like button. I know, Trisha. It does. It means the world to us. Yeah, I'm still in shock. The whole super chat thing. I'm like, what? I think the first time we ever saw one come up, I had no idea what it was. But yeah, we're super appreciative. Thank you so much, Trisha. Without your support, our channel wouldn't be here.
Come on, dude.
Yeah, we appreciate you all for watching. Check out Toontown. This is stroller land over here, in case you were wondering what land I was in. It's stroller land. Yeah, this this thing is gonna have a whole new life. Kind of crazy with Minnie and Mickey's railroad coming. I don't know how this is gonna work. Because this land is not very big. Stay tuned. We're working on our masterpiece. Look at that. Stay tuned. Yeah, we got to ride Runaway Railway in Walt Disney World earlier this year. And yeah, I really liked it. I really did. Chris, I don't know. He was kind of on the fence. Toontown. Yes, we are excited. We just watched the Lion King show. Yeah, Disneyland Paris. It's not gonna be like that, I don't think. The one that they did in Paris was pretty like Broadway style kind of show. I know, I like, where did I put it? Where did I put the stroller? I don't know. they're all in some shade of black. So yeah, you have to put like one of those Apple tags on it so you know where it is.
Let's go find some smart water. Oh,
Herbaba's here. Am I gonna stream? I don't know. Do you guys want me to stream? Do you want me to stream it? I will. I'll be here for a while. I wasn't planning on staying that late, but if that's what you guys want, yeah, why not? But I need to know who wants to see it. If you guys want to see it, let me know. Yeah. Oh, I forgot. You know what I forgot to tell you guys? I'm sure you guys probably already know. Let me go back. Back to the Fantasyland Theater. So besides the show, before I get too far, besides the show, the Troubadour Tavern, where they have the potatoes, they're going to have a whole new menu. Not sure if the regular potatoes are going anywhere, but they're gonna have, it's like a chicken curry sweet potato. They're gonna have some plantains, some fried plantains. I think it was a peach funnel cake, a bunch of drinks. Yeah, it the 28th, this side of the park has been so quiet with this being down for all that time. But right here at the Troubadour Tavern, they are gonna have all this new food. So it's, yeah, this is gonna be busy. Lines for new food here are gonna be busy. Lines to get into this place are gonna be busy. But yeah, this side of the park, being that Toontown is now closed, it needs to be visited by folks, so I'm glad that they're doing that. They're gonna have some new foods also at DCA, so May the 28th is gonna be new shows. We have Lion King show, we have Fantasmic, we have new foods. It's gonna be busy. All right, let's see what's going on the other side of the park. Let's take the back way. Fantasy Fair gifts. Look at this little Mickey, he's so cute. He is adorable. He's 10 bucks and he has his arms and his, I don't know if his legs are moving, but his arms do move. Very cute. All right, we're gonna take the back way. So this is, once the parade is happening, the only way to get from one side of the park, if you're trapped over here, is this little walkway. And even here, people will stop at this railing and try to sneak a peek underneath for the parade. It's kind of funny. And then they get yelled at that they have to keep moving. We've been yelled at before. Won't be the last time, I'm sure. How is my throat? My throat is better. My throat is better. I'm not 100%. I'm still a little nasally, but yeah, the cough, that I call it the death grip cough, because it literally stops you in your tracks. See, I'm gonna start coughing now that I'm talking about it. Yeah, it's the death grip cough isn't an issue anymore. Been drinking lots of hot tea, lots of lozenges. So it's on its way out. Hopefully by Saturday. I know I'm past the contagious stage, though. I think the contagious stage is like 3 days in or something like that for a cold. Walter, the crowd level here today, not good. Not good for a Tuesday. I wish it was a little bit better. Oop, we're going to be walking into the sun. Sorry, guys. I don't want to blind you. Top Gun Maverick is coming out soon. Are we going to be seeing that one, Chris? It's been forever since we've been to the movies. We have, is it Cinemark? I can't remember. Century? One of these movie plans where you basically get a ticket every week, or a couple tickets to go to the movies every weekend or during the week, and we haven't used them. We have a whole bunch saved up, so now we need to go see a bunch of movies. I should get on Dumbo. I should get on Dumbo. Line is kind of long there too. But which line? What line is it? You just gotta find, I guess, the shortest line and get in. Casey Jr. You know, Casey Jr. is long too. Longer than most. It's kind of in the walkway already. Oh, I love Casey Jr. The only problem with being on Casey Jr. is you guys would have to hear me sing. I can't get on that ride without singing. Here we have Dumbo. It's basically the Orbitron, only with elephants. All right. Can't get on that one. Can't get on that one. Maybe I'll find one I can ride. Yep, Cinemark. The most magical thing I experienced was Mission to Mars in Tomorrowland. I thought it was really blasting off. That's the wonderful thing about this place when we were kids. Like, they really did make you think that all that stuff was happening. And now that we're older, we know that they did a really good job making us believe that. But now we get to make the little kids that are here, that we're here with, believe the same thing. It's amazing. Love it. Thor, Love and Thunder is coming out later this year. Yes, we've seen the trailers. It's hilarious. And Natalie Portman comes back. Love that. Yeah, we have to see that. There are definitely certain movies that we have to watch at the theater. Seeing them at home or some kind of a Disney Plus. Ooh! All right. Let me not blind you guys. Let's go into Galaxy's Edge. We'll absolutely see that one in theaters. Yes, we will. Flight to the Moon. Before that one, I did the ride to the moon once. Walter, hi Walter. I don't think I said hi to you yet. Tim Martin, I remember Mars. That was such an amazing experience. Yeah, if they could just bring one of them back. We need some of that. Chris Hemsworth is Thor. Yes, he will always be Thor. They can't replace him. It's not like Batman where they could just, we'll play, you know, get somebody else to play him. Chris Hemsworth has to be. He, like, fits him perfectly. Chris Hemsworth, yeah, he's a he reminds me of a younger Chris, I have to say. So, have you guys noticed that this tree here, so this is in Galaxy's Edge, this is not at Avengers Campus, but it is the same tree that is that Hulk tree at Avengers Campus. It's kind of hard to see because this limb right here, but it gets really narrow right there and then bulges out. So we have a Hulk tree here also. You were the Directory of Engineering at Northrop? J.J. Abrams' sunburst flare effect. I know. But I don't want to blind you guys. It kind of just washes everything out. So one thing I don't mind about, well, besides the fact that I really like coming to Galaxy's Edge and seeing the stormtroopers and Kylo Ren and this amazing TIE fighter, which I can't wait to see if they do a replica at Star Wars Celebration on Saturday. So looking for, or not Saturday, on Thursday. I'll be there on Thursday. I love looking at all that stuff. Can't wait. Director. Disney likes those trees. Yeah, they do. They're neat. They are kind of neat looking. We have Lori Jean. Disneyland Paris is getting Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. Yes, and their Avengers Campus is opening. They said it was going to be open in the summer, and there was no date. Well, we have a release date now for Avengers Campus, which is going to be July 20th. Oh. Does anyone remember the Mad Hatter in Tomorrowland when they used to emboss your name in the hat you purchased? Yes! I was not aware. What? I was not... Oh, aware, you mean. Aware of Disney Paris getting the Galaxy's Edge. Well, the only place they can put it is, if they were going to put it, would be at Hollywood... not Hollywood Studios, at Walt Disney Studios. But I don't know if that is correct. But Avengers Campus, yes, Paris will have that, and it will be open July 20th. We did take some pictures of that when we were there, and the front of it is going to look different. It's going to look much different. That was a great store. All right, so I don't see anybody coming out. We did have somebody screaming over the PA. I thought maybe stormtroopers would make their way out, but they have not. Let's check out the blue milk. I know that cookie that they had here for Star Wars night that had the pistachios and stuff, that's all gone. Things are making their way out. But they do still have the Moncala swirl. And now they have the Toydara swirl. So the Moncala swirl is the one with the mango and the jello bits inside of it. And then they still have the cups. The cups are still here. And they will probably be here through all of May for Star Wars month, or they'll just keep them. Hopefully they just keep them. People want them. Why would they not?
No.
Ooh. Touched the wrong thing. Our Avengers Campus a year ago this year. Let's take a look at this door here. Would love to know what all those little inscriptions and stuff say. Well, we have somebody from Costa Rica. Hello. Hello, Dorian. Yep, our Avengers campus here is still new, although still not a whole lot going on here. You get characters now and again, but you don't really catch them out and about in the wild too often. Chewie, if you get to see him nowadays, you're kind of lucky. Ray, I haven't seen Ray in the land for, seems like forever. I love these living quarters here.
This is the way. Yeah.
Yes, this is the way. There's somebody asleep at the foot of the stairs, so I don't want to really cover that. But this just makes me want to kind of climb up the stairs and, I don't know, sell some Girl Scout cookies. Hello? Anybody home? Yes, we need some Kenobi characters. We need something. We need, although it's not, this land is not old. It just, it's a little stale. 5 to 10 minutes. I do love all the details though. You could just stay here all day and look at everything. Zoom in on everything, like what does that say? What does that mean? It is very cool though. See, here's that tree again. It is the Hulk tree. Another one that's here. The Ogas. August doesn't look to be that busy. The standby doesn't look all that long. Let's see. So we have some people waiting here, and then we have somebody checking people in over here. Not that bad. You'll probably still get a walk up. Too much gamma radiation. Oh, and here we are. It is, this is the line for people wanting pictures with the Millennium Falcon. Did you know that Disneyland shuts down all rides if a major earthquake happens? Who's excited for Obi-Wan Kenobi? Me. I just wish I had tickets for Star Wars Celebration for Saturday, because Ewan McGregor's gonna be there. He is selling his photo with an autograph, and I believe it's a meet and greet also. It was $300. For that opportunity, and it's already sold out. I was going through the celebrities that'll be there. I'm hoping to see Emperor Palpatine. He'll be there all days. So I'm there Thursday, he will be there also. Hoping to catch a glimpse of him. And I think his photo and autograph, I think his is only like $80. Don't tell Chris. Oh, I forgot Chris is on here. I want to climb on underneath here. See what makes this thing tick. Wow, the line has, they just moved it. I'm like, where did this line come from? All right. Let's take a look and see what Smuggler's Run is at. 60 minutes. 60 minutes for this. Well, I don't know if 60 minutes to be an engineer is worth it. But as a pilot, it's fun. Especially that opening where you go into light speed. That's a lot of fun, but the pilot is the only one that can do that. Yeah, this land isn't nearly as crowded as all the others, so I kind of like it coming over here because you get some breathing room. Do we want to go into Doc Ondar's? What do we want to do? Yeah, just don't get stuck being an engineer. Yeah, I think the only other person who had a sold out times for photos and autographs was Billy Lord, and I was really sad about that. I'm a big Carrie Fisher fan, and that's her daughter, Billy Lord. She was in a lot of the movies with her, and everybody has taken up the time slots. I don't remember how much her picture and like her session was going for, but I was really sad. Let's go in here, see what popcorn they're making today. Yeah, I was really sad that I couldn't get a session with her. If I remember correctly, I think it was like $115 or so. There you go. Let's push some buttons. Yeah, nothing. So it looks like they still have the souvenir droid here. We got one of those because we couldn't find the AT-ATs at Star Wars night. Look at this. This is cute. Very, very cute. It seems like the kids always get the best stuff. Oops. Somebody dropped it. Rope drop, rise of the resistance. Yes. Everybody makes their way to rise. Ride at rope drop. That is the best. If you want to ride it, that is the best thing to do. Yes. Well, on your on your way to Rise of the Resistance, what you need to do is get a chimichanga. And then as you're running from the chimichanga cart over to Rise of the Resistance, you can eat it. For Rise of the Resistance, it is a lightning lane. It's at a la carte, so it is $20 for just that one ride. Yeah, Carrie Fisher. I love her. I loved her. Her sense of humor, everything about her. And then she's just a legend. She's a legend when it comes to Star Wars. She's helped start it all. There will not be another. And the thing that really, really makes me love her is that when you push the water button, the little creature comes out. Is it gonna come out? Yeah. There he is. I don't know if you can see him. Ooh. You can see the eyeball. The eyeball comes out of the water. Yeah, but just like a an unknown, I don't know if you guys are aware, but Carrie Fisher, when she passed, she was cremated. Hi, Disney ducks. How are you? I don't have any popcorn for you. Oh. Yeah, when she passed, she was cremated, and she had her remains put into an urn that was shaped like a Prozac pill. Now, if that doesn't say you have a sense of humor, even after death, I don't know what does. This is a really cool rock. I love the formation and the color. So many cool things. Hi, Ruth. How are you? I have Chris on the other side. He's across the country, so he's helping moderate and typing in all the comments. Yep, she was a great ghostwriter. I love all her movies. Postcards from the Edge. It's fantastic too. Yeah, not that she was in Postcards from the Edge, but it was her story. Her and her mom. Now that was a true love story. Join the resistance. Now when they opened this land, I got a mug. Chris was here for the opening. It was a cast preview, and he got me a black mug, and it says Black Spire on it, and I haven't seen it since. I don't know if maybe it was a cast preview exclusive? Don't know. Look at these. These are all die cast. We have the T-70X swing. We have a die cast vehicle. Look at this vest. Look at that. And then for summer, yes, you need this. You're gonna need this for summer for sure. This is a cute woman's shirt. I think it's a woman's shirt. It is tapered on the edges, so Millennium Falcon. That's really cute. This is $36.99. I like that. Might have to take one home one day. All right. What does Rise of the Resistance look like? What is the queue looking like? Looks a little blurry from here. 60 minutes. Standby is at 60 minutes. If you really want to ride it, you can ride this, which is way cool. This ride is really, really cool. Or you could ride Star Tours. That was 60 minutes too. I would much rather ride this one. Where are we at in the chat? Me too, Princess Leia, Queen. Oh, I think I'm all cut up. Oh, no. Yeah, that's not bad. It's really not. What is it? You need to get on a ride, maybe Small World. I don't know. Maybe we let the chat tell us where they want us to ride. Now it has to be something that's not gonna get me in trouble for having this this phone and gimbal in my hand when I ride it, though. That's for sure. I want you guys to be able to see the ride and enjoy the ride with me. Yeah, if you guys want me to jump on a ride, I would be more than happy to do it. Maybe even the train. I'm still thinking maybe I should get on the train. Hello, chat folks. Hi, library lady. Have you ever built your own lightsaber at Savvy's? Yes, we did. Adrian? Chris built one. We do have a video out on that. We were really lucky when Chris built one, there were not a lot of people in his session. It was basically only one side, and it wasn't even filled. I'm trying to remember which one he built. Power and... Do you remember, Chris, which one you built?
But he kept, like, looking at his fingers.
Power and control, I think it was. It was the red, with the red kyber crystal. So we have a couple at home. We have a couple legacy lightsabers, and then the one that Chris built. I think I need one. Ooh, we are coming out. Oh, maybe we'll get on the Pooh. Maybe we should get on Winnie the Pooh. What is your favorite part of Star Wars Land? Star Wars Land. Of Galaxy's Edge. My favorite part is the Millennium Falcon. I could stand under the Millennium Falcon and just gaze at that all day long. And when it throws the smoke from underneath, like it's actually on, is very cool. Yeah, the Falcon, for sure. For sure! All right, guys. I was gonna say, let's get on Winnie the Pooh, but even the Winnie the Pooh is like 20 minutes. It's 20 minutes. It is a fast 20 minutes though. What do you guys think? Should we get on? And of course the Diet Coke bottles, yes. The Diet Coke bottles are back. They are back, they are very cute. The only bad thing is you don't get much in them. Should we do it? You guys tell me, should we do Winnie the Pooh? It's 20 minutes. Is it really worth 20 minutes? Chris and I love to come in the evening and do this ride when it's 5 minutes. So I'll be willing to do 20. We have Adrian saying yes. Ruth. We have Chris. Yes, Winnie the Pooh, my favorite character. Do it. Okay. All right, guys. Let's do it. I love Eeyore when at the end when he says, if you don't like my gift, you can take it back. I love that part. Okay, I'm going to look how cute this is. This little covered bridge, I love it. It is very cute. Everything about this ride is very cute. Even when you end and it has the little bees that buzz by the beehive, it's very, very adorable. Let's see. Yep, library lady. Sure, Winnie the Pooh. So while you're in line, tell everyone why you love Chris so much. Okay. I have to spill the beans. Chris, close your ears. I don't want this to go to your head. Oh, yes, I love my Christopher. I wish he was home with me. But, you know, bills have to be paid. Things have to happen. But he's a wonderful individual. I'm sure you guys, just by looking at his face, can tell. Eeyore is such, is such a mood, I know. I'm going to try to point you guys away from everybody the entire time we're in line. I think I've mentioned this on the past live streams. I don't like when people are live streaming or filming and my face is there for the entire time when people are behind me. So I try not to do that to other people. I try to be considerate. I'm sure they don't like it. I know I don't like it. Look at this pond. All right, we're riding. Yes, the face of an angel, Christopher. Yes, you have the face of an angel. And the name of a saint. Yes. Well, you deal with me, and I'm no picnic, so. thank you, Frankie B. calm? We try to be, but Chris has things that he wants to do, and I have things I want to do and show you guys, and sometimes they don't match, so yeah, it's a compromise. You have to, if you're going to be married, you have to compromise. They should put some fish in here. I see lots of change. Maybe that's why they don't. If they put change, or if they put fish in here, I think the fish would want to eat it. Do I like Ray? I do like Ray. I was a little confused about her in the beginning. Like her storyline, she was very mysterious, but now that everybody knows about her, where she came from, which was still really, people don't really know too much. But yeah, she's all right. Thank you, library lady. Yes, we do. We try to. I'm kind of in the middle here. Sorry. I'm going to film myself, maybe? Oh. Yeah. I have a Ray lightsaber. So. Yes, we are very excited about the Obi-Wan series. We cannot wait. I'm going to film some bushes for you guys. Sorry. But on this part of the queue, there's basically people to the left and people to the right. Up. Try to protect people's privacy as best we can. Meow. Here we go. That's the top of the covered bridge. And then you have Hungry Bear right here that has that delicious honey peach drink, that slush. Oh, so good. Can't wait for Obi-Wan. I know. It's going to be so good. I mean, if it's even a half as good as what they've shown us so far for the trailer, it's going to be amazing. In the middle of the poo ride, you can see the characters. Yeah. So this ride, the Winnie the Pooh ride, used to be the Country Bear Jamboree, which was one of my favorites as a kid. Same as Chris. He loved this ride as well. And they did save a couple of items Oh, got Winnie the Pooh playing. They did save a couple of items from the ride, which they usually try to. They don't like to completely wipe a ride of what it used to be. They'll keep little remnants of something, and they have three folks here. When we get to that part, I will show you. We have seen The Mandalorian. Yes. This is the way. Absolutely. Love The Mandalorian. Love Grogu or Baby Yoda. I will always refer to him as Baby Yoda. I wonder if the train's going to go by. We can't wait for the next season. Yep, the Country Bear Jamboree. So if you want to see the Country Bear Jamboree, you have to go to Walt Disney World now, or you go to Tokyo. DISNEYLAND Tokyo has it there too. And they sing half in Japanese and half in English. It is really, really fun. Seemed like the Walt Disney World version of the Country Bear Jamboree was a lot, like they cut it short. There were certain characters that we didn't see, or if they came out, it was like their song was cut short for some reason. Yes, The Mandalorian forever. Yes, Chris, cool tribute for the Country Bear Jamboree. Remember the first time we saw that was, what is it? Yeah, we only get the three heads. We'll show you once we get in there. Hopefully I don't get the back row, because if I get the back row, I won't be able to turn around and show you. It's kind of funny because a lot of people still don't know about that. If you're just going along the ride and you're looking forward and maybe up and down, you don't notice it's there. You have to literally turn around in your seat to see it. Maybe I'll turn it around. Say hi to you guys. Ooh. Hi! How is everybody? Take a look. Isn't there a big tribute to a bug? A Bug's Landing Adventures Campus. Yeah, now they have one of the characters come around with a miniature of Bug's Life. Grogu. It's probably the same age as Anakin, Darth Vader. Yeah, they said he was like 50. Right? I think that's what they said. But he was 50. Okay, let's turn you back around. I'm sure you guys don't want to see me close up. Look at my ears.
Ta-ta for now.
Ta-ta for now.
Bueno, nosotros somos unos apasionados de la seguridad. Por lo tanto, permanezcan sentados.
These ears I got from Paris, they match the Spirit jersey. It's kind of weird that they didn't have this set of ears here. They have a teal Spirit jersey with the neon yellow writing in the back, but they never came out with the ears here. So when we were in Paris back in October for Halloween, I was able to grab these. Look how cute. Okay, here we go, guys. Was it 20 minutes? One, Five, thank you. All right, we're in row five, so not the back, almost the back. But that didn't, I don't know, it didn't seem like it was 20 minutes. Trisha, you still need to ride web slingers? Wow. Yeah. At least now they make it easier because you don't have to have a boarding group. When that ride first came about, it was pretty bad. People wanted to get on it and they'd make reservations for the day and then they wouldn't be able to get a boarding group. But now they actually have single riders too. Here we go. Hopefully we don't lose connectivity. I don't think we've ever...
Lower your bars and loosen up. Lower and lift.
Hopefully we don't lose connectivity. Let's do this. It's the Heimlich car, yes. All right. Jumbled us around all over the place. Oh, it worked great. Awesome. We thought we were going to lose you guys in there. Here we go. And on to our next adventure. What's next? Thank you. That was fun. I'm glad to hear that it streamed well. That's always a concern, that it's not going to look great. Small World. Chris, you are stuck on Small World. I need to put you guys down for a minute because my sweater, I have it tied around my waist and it is falling down. All right, there we go. All right. I'm just glad you guys aren't, didn't ask for a water ride. That would be horrible. I didn't bring the right shoes for a water ride. Hi, Buzos from the Bay. Love that they left the heads in the ride. Yeah. Yeah, I figure I gotta take you guys on some rides with me. Although we could walk around the park all day, find very interesting things. Oh, Splash Mountain. It's not bad. 30 minutes. 30 minutes. And it's not exactly cold out here, so I could see people wanting to take advantage of that and enjoy the ride. You'd still have enough time to drive. Look at this guy. He's got his bow tie, ready to serve you a burger and a soda. It's amazing. All right, let's go look at the Rivers of America. Let's see, what questions have I missed? Let's see. You're very welcome, Frankie's Bride. I love taking you guys on rides. Did you go on Pirates of the Caribbean? Yep. Pirates is down.
No. Here, I won't do anything to you.
It's expected to be open July 1st. Can't wait to see what was updated on Pirates. I'm afraid. Bye, Trisha. Have a nice night, and thank you once again for your super chat. That was super, super nice of you. You are very kind. Thank you very much. Have a good night, and tomorrow you'll be finding tracking info for your giveaway prize, your Elliot. Those are all going out tomorrow. So I know you live somewhat close, so you'll be getting that very, very soon. And I forgot. You know what? I completely forgot. If there is anyone here in the park watching, or if you know someone who's here at the park that that watches our channel, I have a shirt. I have a shirt to give away. It's a long sleeve black t-shirt with the Walker Chronicles on it. I also have some buttons and some stickers. When we did our last live stream on Sunday, people were asking for shirts and merch, inquiring on that. So I brought a shirt. It's a long sleeves tee. It's a large, but I figure it fits me. So if small, medium, large, you can give it to a family member or anything like that. But yeah, I have one available to give away to somebody tonight, or if we don't give it away tonight, then we'll bring it along at another time. Jungle Cruise. Adventureland. All right, let's do Jungle Cruise. Let's do it. We did a pretty good job with we did a pretty good job with Pooh's adventure. So yeah, let's do that. Same here. We do the country bears from our childhood. But I'm glad they left an Easter egg. I know. So at least it's not completely gone. We should ride the Haunted Mansion. Yeah, I would love to, but I would lose you guys. That's one of the bad things. Oh, and it looks... it's actually closed right now. It is down. Haunted Mansion is down. So, yeah, even if we didn't lose connection in there, that elevator, we would eventually pop back up, but we would lose some connection there. But it's down, unfortunately. And Tim, does Disneyland still have those huge Mickey Mouse lollipops? I know I've seen lollipops at World of Disney, but I haven't seen any here. It's probably because the kids break them, and then they stick to the floor. Oh, you're welcome, Trisha. We appreciate you so much. I'm glad that you've been riding the Walker Chronicles journey from early on. How long was the Haunted Mansion line? The line, it was just basically people milling about because the ride is down. And you have cast members that are asking people to back up and to move. All right, let's go check out the Jungle Cruise. Bubbles, Chris's favorite bubbles. Let's see. They don't have a sign out front for Jungle Cruise when I came by earlier. You just kind of have to gauge it, whether it's kind of backed up out of the front entrance. Look at, here's Royal 21. This is a place that many want to go, but few have been. This is like a $15,000 experience. Royal 21. Yeah, Club 33 got nothing on this. $15,000. If you have $15,000, you too can enjoy Royal 21. It's crazy. I have $15,000. I don't think I'm gonna waste it on dinner. At least not me. Pirates back. Yes. July 1st. Not if they sell them or not. Yeah, I can take a peek at one of the candy stores. Maybe we'll go into Marceline's. Yes, $1,250 a person. That is correct. I think I'm going the wrong way. All right, in we go. You know what, I guess I probably should have looked at how long the line was. I'm gonna make you guys sick with all the turns. It is very loud in here. Let's point you this way. Bye, beautiful people. It is getting very dark in here. Hopefully the I'm gonna point you guys down. Sorry. This queue is very tight. There's really nothing to look at on the left or the right side of me other than people, so I'm gonna try to get through this queue and show as few people as possible. The schematic of the boat. Those lollipops were about 15 inches wide and they tried to sell them to the candy store many years ago. Yeah, sometimes the wait time on the Jungle Cruise is... Oh, I just missed Frankie's ride. Oh, I lost it. Yeah, the queue on this ride is so tight, especially upstairs. I don't see anybody upstairs. Oh, maybe I do. I see some feet. Yeah, the queue upstairs is so tight that there are times you're touching shoulders with the person on each side of you. Wow. Here's something. Look at all this stuff. Like, where did they find all this stuff?
This just in. A winner has been named in our annual Skipper Art competition. The winning piece is Banana in the Savannah by Skipper Hannah. Well, I know I'm not a fan of. Speaking of winners, the annual River League Softball Championship game is tonight. Come watch as the Jungle Navigation Company's boat crashes through takes on the Tiger Tails of Bengal.
Thirty minutes. Yeah, we still have to go upstairs, so it's probably right. Oh, making of the Jungle Cruise. Yeah, I have not seen the making of the Jungle Cruise. Although, I will tell you, we have a family member who is extremely shy, and they used to work this attraction. I don't know how they managed. They would never let us come on board to see them. So here you have your two line split. And now I'm gonna be showing you the floor instead of all the people. Yeah, our family member, they've been here for quite some time, but this was an attraction that they worked, and they were super shy. They're no longer working. They still work here for the park, but they had made us a promise that they would let us come on their very last day, and that it never happened. I would have loved to have seen them on the ride, telling the jokes. They were a captain. Let's show you all this stuff up here. All these lanterns. Expedition Everest, yep. It was down. But we'll be able to go on it this year. As long as they don't close it again or it's not broken. Oop. I let it drift. Sorry, guys.
I'm
So what side are we hoping we get on? I hope I don't get the middle. I hope I don't get the middle. That would be awful. That's right. Chris did find the manual back in 72. Yep. I think we still have that, right? We have a lot of miscellaneous Disney memorabilia, and Chris still finds a lot of it, brings it home. We need to, we do. Universal Studios, yeah, we have season passes for Universal Studios, but it's really far. Well, it's a good hour from the house, so we kind of have to plan.
And it says
our big trips into Universal are for HHN for Halloween Horror Nights. That's Chris's favorite season, Halloween. He can't get enough of it. It's our busiest season too. We're basically at a haunt every night. So we're doing home haunts, we're doing the big theme park haunts. It's gonna be another busy season. I basically don't sleep the whole month of October. Upstairs, and we've come upstairs. That's how this queue works. You go from the downstairs to the upstairs, and then you go back downstairs and get on the boat. This line usually moves pretty quick. What is that? Adventureland. With the flag. Want to see a great video of the scariest attraction at any Disneyland park? Search for Mystery Tour of Tokyo Disney.
Attention Jungle Cruise passengers, your attention please. When you reach the top of the stairs and down by the loading dock, the line will split into two separate lines, one on the left and one on the right. Please go ahead and choose the shorter of the two lines and please keep your party together. Thank you.
Yeah, Halloween. As long as there are no chainsaws, I'm good. Once the chainsaws come out, I'm a puddle of mud. I'm gonna aim you guys up at the trees. Yeah, this is the part where it gets so tight. There are so many people on this. I'm just gonna give you guys a peek. This is the craziest queue ever. They really need to make two of these lines into one, because it is so tight. See, did you guys know Haunted Car last year? Oh, the Haunted Car Wash. Did we do the Haunted Car Wash last year? We had tickets to it. We showed up and the line was probably 2.5 hours. So we did not. Yeah, we did not, unfortunately. I know they're supposed to be having another one this year.
As a reminder to all skippers,
yeah, hopefully we can make it.
Be sure to lock your food storage locker after each use. Monkeys have been seen sneaking around.
Oh, Adrian, you worked the haunted corn maze. We did a corn maze last year. That was probably the best haunted maze that we had been through.
Congratulations, Sam. And now, back to
you can't do clowns. Yeah, I'm not so scared of clowns as long as they don't have a chainsaw. They have a clown and a chainsaw, I'm done. Yeah, a corn maze is no joke, for sure. So I hope you guys don't mind looking at the ceiling. Again, trying to keep everybody out of the frame.
How's nature?
Yes, Chris loved the corn maze. The guy who jumped out with the chainsaw. I was trembling. They asked if we wanted to go back in. And Chris did. He went by himself, but I couldn't do it. I was so terrified. Yoda. Yep, it looks like we do one more turn, and then we get to go downstairs, and then it's probably about another 5 minutes. Here's some weird stuff. Look at this. They've taken bugs and framed them so that those are very interesting. Not something I would put in my house, but they're interesting. Very attraction appropriate. Especially this guy right here. Look at that. Can you imagine that flying and landing on you? Horrible. I don't think I've ever been this close to these frames here. I'm usually on the inside track. He just walked by you to your left. Who just walked by me to my left? Okay, up. Pointing you guys down now. Yeah, it is a very tight squeeze right here. We're nearing the steps, so we should get a little breathing room, but right now, woo! I was literally touching the shoulders of people on the left and right of me. It's like you have to hug the wall.
Yeah, I see that.
Look at how... Wow, it is so These stairs here are so tight. But we are headed downstairs, so just a little bit longer before we get on a boat. Yes, Chris is a huge horror fan. Meadowbrook Pumpkin Farm. My sons were chased by a chainsaw wielding clown a couple of years ago. It was so scary. That house took Halloween seriously. My boys were teens, yeah. Yeah, I don't get... I'm not afraid of jump scares. I'm not afraid of clowns or monsters. That kind of thing. It's the chainsaw. Even the sound of a chainsaw. We went to the Laguna Hills? Laguna... I can't remember the name of it. Gosh, that... We have a video out. Maybe Chris can remind me which place it was. But they had a chainsaw wielding guy there. It was Leatherface, and he followed me all the way down the trail. I froze in fear. I stood still with my eyes closed, and Chris had to grab me by the hand and get me out of there because I was literally frozen in fear. It was that bad. All right, we're on the bottom floor. Just a little while longer until we get onto a boat and go for a cruise. Was it Laguna Woods? It was the haunted trail. Laguna Hills? I can't remember. That haunt started off really mellow, and then it turned into my worst nightmare. I don't think I've ever screamed so hard in my life. And Chris laughed at me the entire way. It was funny when it was over, but not when I was going through it. Are we gonna make it on this boat? I hope not.
And I'll get you on the next boat.
Thank you. Yay. So we'll be on the next boat. We'll be the first person. So hopefully we get to sit on one of the signs. One. Bye. We're next. I think we're getting on this just in time. I think by the time we get off of this, it's going to be dark. Oh, there's only like one person on this boat.
Watch your head, watch your step, use those handrails. Come on, all the way around. I promise I don't bite anymore. I got something.
Welcome in. Drop the watcher, how to watch your steps, lower your head, lower your expectations while you're at it. It'll make things easier. Is this anybody's first time on the jumbo? Curry's first time. Oh, really? It's my first time too. Look at that. We're all in the same boat. Who knew?
Bye bye, beautiful people. I know, they don't have another thing to say. Maybe they will this
Welcome
time.
Welcome in, folks. Those of you in the back, you're sitting on the battery. Don't worry, free charge. There's both positive and negative sides to that. Negative side is the VIP section. Dance review is pathetic. I'm just kidding. No, I'm not. Sorry about that spotlight. I'm going to turn it off in a little bit. I don't like to share it anyways. Then you guys haven't seen the doorway. You know what that'll make you? Adorable. Aww. All right, three magical words.
That's good.
I was hoping for an I love you, but alright. Wait, somebody, the night skipper's on the dock. Wait, somebody, skipper Nando in the back. It's his first, it's last day, actually. He just doesn't know it yet. Anyways, welcome aboard the world famous Jumbo Cruise Boat. My name is Folia. I will be your skipper, guide, hippo wrestler, dance instructor, and quite possibly your swimming instructor. So for your safety, please remain seated with your hands on the elbows inside the boat. What? And parents, please watch your children. And children, please watch your parents. Sometimes they're worse. Yeah, I wanted to apologize for all that mist you just saw. I forgot to mention that I have a spitting problem. I'm sorry. Alright, who's ready to see some danger? Woohoo! There it is! Danger! With an exclamation point! And if you happen to lose anything or throw anything overboard, feel free to just raise your hand, okay? And then I'll raise my hand. And then we'll both wave goodbye to it together. Perfect. Now that I got that out of the way, we're gonna start our cruise off here on the right. It is the Temple of the Forbidden Eye, where famous archaeologist Indiana Jones is searching for the world's greatest treasure. Why he's searching in there, I don't know. I'm standing right here, so. I don't want to scare anybody, but there's only a 500-pound Himalayan tiger. Right there. Yeah, it's a Himalayan tiger. Don't get it confused. As you can see, him a-standing. Oh, look, there's my friends from high school. Hey, guys. Small world.
Oh.
And on the left, we have a monumental statue of an elephant who lost his contact lens. Poor guy. Oh, wow, would you look at that? Looks like we come across a secret bathing pool of Indian elephants. You know, it's okay to stare. They got their trunks on. But if you do happen to take any pictures, please don't get any of me. Yeah, my mom thinks I'm a doctor, so that would be extremely awkward. Oh, wow, the whole herd's here. That's pretty unheard of. Wow. Oh, look, there's Bertha in the shower. Hey, Bertha. You know, she's actually the prime example of what happens when you shower too long, folks. You turn into an elephant. It almost happened to me once. No, just kidding. I was kidding. I wouldn't know. I don't shower, so. Up on the right, my favorite squirt. What are you doing, Tom? This is not a water ride, excuse you. Why are you trying to aim it at me? Don't hit me. Get the gas, get up. Everyone, duck. There's a cute duck over there. Yeah, it's gone now, but I wouldn't refer to an actual danger. Don't, what? Oh. Oh, well, that looks dangerous, doesn't it? Let's get closer. Yeah, so it looks like we're entering banana country, folks, so keep your eyes peeled in case we need to split. Oh, that's so cute. It's a girl with a gun. How adorable. Yeah, I hope nobody's wearing the color yellow. If you are, please don't make any sound that sounds like a banana. They find that quite appealing. As we're approaching the bamboo here on the left, make sure you take a real good look right in between those two branches. You will find absolutely nothing. Oh, that's something you don't see every day. I'm kidding, I see it every day. But straight ahead is Schweitzer Falls. It is named after our founder of the Jumbo Navigation Company, Albert Falls. Yeah, if you didn't get that, don't worry. We're going over it later.
Here's the front side of water.
We are now onto the Nile River. You know, it's actually the longest river in the world. Yeah, so long. It goes on for Niles and Niles and Niles and Niles. You get the point. It's long. Yeah, it's actually 400 Niles. Crazy, right? Yeah. If you don't believe me, though, you're in denial, obviously. On the left, that's a large African bull elephant. You know, I actually heard they're the fastest animals in the world. So fast that if you don't believe me, look, it's right there. Wow, that's crazy. Alrighty, folks. So I hope you're all familiar with the famous Jungle Cruise movie, inspired by, well, yours truly. So I thought I would introduce the star of the film. Check it out, it's The Rock. Wow. Pretty underwhelming if you ask me, but we are in the African boat, and there are some stripy horses, some bearded cows, and those tall things in the back, those are trees. Oh, I think the stripy horses are the oldest, though. They're in black and white. Oh, one of them is taking a nap. He looks dead. Tired, get tired. Sorry, let's just let him rest in peace, or pieces, as it were. Oh, that's weird. You know, the last time I checked that tree trunk, it had no lips, and well, now it has about 20. Yeah, the skipper fuel to the bottom. It was the first and, well, last way now, and that's the VIP crew. I haven't seen them in about 8 hours or so. I actually think one of them is named Bruno, but we don't talk about him. Oh, whoops, I made a wrong turn. I'm sorry. It looks like we're actually entering the hippo pool. It's fine. Last week, they capsized 2 of our boats. That's the least they've ever done, so we have nothing to worry about. Both of them are mine, but you know, this has to talk, so we're gonna go. Okay, that didn't last long at all. Alright, folks, bring everyone cover your ears while I try to scare them off. Cover your ears. Okay, that didn't work. Hold on, I have a backup plan. I love you. Let's get married. Be here forever and ever and ever. Look at that, we're never gonna hear from them again. You're welcome. It works every time. Straight ahead, I'm gonna deal with this boat. Well, at least part of it, and it has to be recursive, as you can see. Some may say this boat's been officially chip-wrecked. Wow. You know, if you're thinking of buying a boat, you totally should get that one. It's half off. What a great deal. Above the left, we have the double cruises, most beloved sisters. The one on the left, that's Maggie. And on the right, her sister, Annette. Yeah, you know, I just love their confidence. You know, nothing bugs them. Probably why Annette is such a catch. All right, folks. It's the moment you've all been waiting for. Eighth most wonderful wonder of the world. I'm gonna need a pig. Big round of applause for the backside of water! O2H! No, that's not crowd pleaser, but if you aren't pleased, you're not. There's something for everybody. On the right side, here's the front side of rock. Yeah, it's one of our bolder attractions, but I do think people take it for granted, but it's always gonna have deep sediment in my heart. Okay then. Anyways, I want to show you a great fishing area. You know, my boss Alberto said the fish were always biting, and I'm no fish fanatic, so I don't know what that means. We're gonna figure it out. Oh, okay, bad fishies, they're piranhas. They're actually hungry piranhas. That's weird. I wonder how they traveled all the way here from Hungary and seems far. Up on the left, that's a large python. I know it's not a boa because it doesn't have any feathers, obviously. And what is a cruise without a beautiful gift shop? This is Trader Sam's, and I know what you're thinking. Julio, why did you leave the monkeys in charge? I didn't. That would be a horrible, horrible idea. So I left the elephant in charge. Hey, Ellie. I bought my first crew back. Aren't you proud? Oh, you like them? Oh, I'm so rude. I'm sorry. But both of them think she's boiling water. Don't worry. It's not. Alright, well, I guess it's just time to let you know you will survive the world famous jumbo cruise. Give yourselves a round of applause, folks. Woo-hoo!
Keep it
moving,
you're our favorite.
You're my favorite. Who said that? As we're approaching the dock, please remain seated with your hands, arms, elbows inside the boat. I don't want anyone scratching up my beautiful dock. Honestly, out of all my groups I've had today, you guys were definitely one of them. I'm just kidding. You guys were my favorite group, and I mean that every time. And make sure we're all seated. Perfect. Alrighty, here we go, folks. Yeah, you're my favorite group, and I mean that every time. An outstanding crew you were, an outstanding crew indeed, but soon I'll meet you outstanding. Somewhere else. I do want to end this cruise out on a high note, however. Get out.
Hi, friends,
please, get out. My double side, you're going to be hooked all the way down by the rear. Of the boat, don't make this weird. Watch your head, watch your step, use those handrails, folks. Watch your head, watch your step, use those handrails. And if you happen to miss a step and hit your head, then watch your language. There's children everywhere. Remember, folks, at the end of the day, it's night.
Yes, at the end of the day, it's night. Ooh, we got on that just in time. We were still able to see everything without the lights that they have, and they shine them on certain areas. Sorry if I was whipping you guys around a little bit. But that's just kind of how it goes, especially on that particular ride. I need to adjust my bag. So I'm gonna put you guys down again for a minute. So who's still here? Put some power to this phone. I can smell the Bengal barbecue. Smells so good. All right, so what do we want to do next? It's starting to get dark. Filming, doing live streams at night, depending on the quality of the picture, can get a little tricky. I know, I didn't know if my head was going to end up on one of those sticks at Trader Sam's. Let's take a look at the castle at night. Cannot go home and not see the castle at night. All right, let's go through. What is it? So Chris is heading out for the night. He is 3 hours ahead of me. He's on the East Coast, so good night, honey. I love you. I miss you. I miss you. Have a good night and call me in the morning, of course. So everybody's getting ready. They're lining up for the electrical parade. Oh, look at these guys. Too sweet. I love these little statues. They keep them so shiny too. Looks like the top of Donald's hat has a little bit of a, I think people like to rub his hat because it's got some rub marks on it. But he's so cute. They should sell a set of these. Good night, Christopher. Sweet dreams, honey. All right, so we have made our rounds. We've gone through Tomorrowland, gone through Galaxy's Edge. I think they've already closed off the bridge to the castle. We didn't go through the castle. Let's see if they have blocked it off. Yeah, the spots for the parade, for the early parade, they go really quick. And we make our way through to the castle. Nope, they have blocked it off. Let me go the other way. So I can't go through the castle into DISNEYLAND. I need to see what time it is. Is it, how? 8:10. Yeah, no wonder all the curbs and parade areas are already filling up. They're probably going to be making, from what I can tell, they're probably going to be making an announcement that all the areas to view are filled, because it is packed.
Oh, now I know what everyone's here.
Looking for a place I can squeeze in, but I don't think so.
It's an anniversary.
Yeah. We'll see what it looks like closer to the hub, but I think all the spots are gone. Whoa.
So just make sure that you're right here before.
I would say this street is a good 9.75 as far as the pack meter. My goodness. Yep, I can't squeeze in on either side. Huh. Well, no, it's when it comes to this parade, it's like, kind of funny. The first parade, this is the way it looks like every day. But if you come around for the second parade, even I would say 15 minutes before that second parade starts, you can actually still find space. When Chris and I were leaving the Skyline Lounge experience, we were headed out. The second parade was, I would say, maybe 15 to 20 minutes before it started. And yeah, it was pretty easy to find a space, like a good space. You could sit on the curb. Not for this first one. This first one has all the families that want their kids to see it, and then as soon as it's over, they want to get out of here. It's time to go home after that one. Yeah, that's what I was thinking of too. We'll go up to the train station and hopefully be able to squeeze in just one space. We just need one space. I will stand behind somebody and make myself as small as possible. Nope, they saw me looking and made themselves real big. let's try the train station, guys. Hopefully we can find something there. It won't, if we get something at the train station, it won't be the best view. Because we'll be from up above, but it'll be a view. Let's see. They're gonna make me go all the way around. Looks like there might be some space. I might just,
sorry.
Oop, no worries. Can I get up to the front? Maybe. Let's give this a shot. It looks like there might be some space on the other side. I think some folks just took the one little spot that I was looking at. maybe here? How's this, guys?
It's going to be a light show.
Greetings, everyone. In just 30 minutes, experience the excitement and the glorious spectacle of the most electrifying parade in Disney history.
As soon as people see you scoping out an area, they try to make themselves bigger so they so that you avoid them, and I do. I usually do. I just, if they don't want me there, I don't want to be there. But this is our spot. I think we got a decent spot. Yeah, I'm really happy with the view that we have here. Now, we won't get any close-ups So sorry about that. But this is as good as it's gonna get, I think. I think we still have some time too. Let me check my, time. 8:17. Yeah, we have a little bit of time left. So who's excited for Fantasmic? Fantasmic and the Lion King show and the new food. I'm excited for the new food. I really want to try that chicken curry sweet potato. That is screaming my name.
Do you have to go to the bathroom too? Okay. Maybe
both of you? You have to go to the bathroom? No. Stay on
the line. So you want to go with you?
No.
Yeah, we're gonna get aerial views. An aerial view of the parade. I usually like to get some close-ups, but not today. We would have had to have camped out or attended the second parade. Thank you, Frankie. Frankie's bride. Yeah, I think we're good. There are so many people. There are people gathering behind me now. I think they saw those empty little spaces and thought, oh, I'm gonna go try to grab one. Thank you, Frankie's Bride. Yeah, be like Frankie's Bride and hit that like button. Hit that like button. We're going to be here watching the Main Street Electrical Parade. We have an aerial view, which is pretty, I think it's pretty good. This is a pretty good spot. If you're not yet subscribed to the channel, hit that little red subscribe button. We cover theme parks, travel, food, and fun. If it's fun, we're there. We like to do all different kinds of things, not just theme parks. Ooh, it is starting to get a little chilly. It was rather warm earlier this afternoon, and now it's like somebody turned off the heater. Let's see. So is there anybody going to be in the park this weekend? I know Chris and I, we have another reservation to come into the park, not only for the 28th for Saturday, but we'll also be here on the holiday weekend. It's going to be pretty crowded. Oh, thank you, Ginger. Yeah, it was our first time at the Skyline Lounge. Yeah, the other way you didn't just jump from float to float. Yeah, we got really lucky. One of our good friends was holding a spot, and they let us jump in right in front of It's a Small World. And thank goodness, that's the first parade, that's where it starts. So it's gonna take a minute for them to make their way all the way down Main Street and get to us. And then for the second parade, it starts in this area. It comes out over by the Mad Hatter hat shop. But we were lucky enough that we got to squeeze in with him. And then as soon as it was over, we followed them, the parade, all the way down until we could get to that break for Tomorrowland. It was actually a lot of fun following the parade and seeing the dancers. I really want to learn the dance that they do on the way. Those folks that hold the rope, they have a really fun dance. You'll be back in 2 weeks. That's pretty good though. Yep, and we have announcements on Magic Key, so they will be renewing Magic Key, so that's a good thing. Can't wait for that. We have no information on what the cost will be, of course. Hopefully it's in line with what we're paying now, and maybe a few changes. Not maybe, we know that the reservation system is here to stay, unfortunately, but maybe the number of reservations that you can book might change. Crossing our fingers on that. We will see what happens. Yeah, we're also waiting to see what's going to happen for Fantasmic. How are they? Is it going to be a virtual queue? If you think about it, it kind of has to be a virtual queue. If you didn't get dining package reservations or the dining to go from Hungry Bear, The only other way to see that show, Fantasmic, is the virtual queue. So, yeah, it's going to be fun at the end of this parade, because everybody that we saw sitting on that curb and all the people that are here, they're all going to be making their way out at the same time. So the trams are going to be packed. Yeah, it's going to be lots of fun. maybe I'll walk back to the car. Who knows? Upgrading to the news about getting magic keys. Upgrading magic keys. I'm hoping to upgrade. Yeah, you should be able to upgrade. I think once the renewal starts, they have to open Dream Keys. I don't know what key you have or which one you're looking to upgrade. If you have a lower key, you can upgrade now. There are still those two bottom tier keys. Yeah, but it is I believe it's a 40-day window that they're giving us to renew. They're explaining to everyone in the front rows that there is no flash photography. I love the Emporium too. They have everything. They have everything. I just love how the stores on both sides, you can walk from one end of Main Street to basically the other. I love that. And you can shop the entire way down. Yeah. I needed to go into the Emporium to see if they had any more of the Main Street Electrical Parade spirit jerseys. We were gone. We were in Paris when they released them, and I was like, oh no. Those in the lounge flyers, I think, were released. We've been waiting for them since opening day of the parade. And of course, they released them when we're out of the country. But the Emporium loves our bank accounts. They have so much good stuff in there. It's just after a while, you have so much, you've acquired so much. You're like, what do I do with all this? Wow. I think it was kind of weird how Disney World had the jersey before we did. We had the pet ones. If you wanted one for your dog, you could get one of those. But Disney World had the lounge fly. They had the spirit jersey. I don't quite understand. I don't understand how that worked. Uh-oh.
No, he's right there.
Hi, Emily. Yeah, I feel like we got a good spot. It's just me, so I was able to squeeze in up here. But I can tell you now there's no more room to squeeze in. Oh, I would kill for some popcorn right now.
Remember we went to Star Wars?
I should have grabbed some. Yep, I should have grabbed some before I came up here. So then the music would have drowned it out, me chewing on the popcorn. Yeah, I have not seen any of the Elliot popcorn buckets or the sippers. Every time we're here, I'm looking to see if people are carrying them, and another day without popcorn bucket and sipper today. There's the official notice. All spots are officially filled. Well, came up here just in time. Did we get an at popcorn bucket? I did get an at popcorn bucket. Yeah, they did have them at the Galactic Grill. There's a popcorn stand right in front. And they had quite a few there, so I was lucky enough to get one of those. I haven't put any popcorn in it, and I probably won't. I'm just going to put the popcorn bucket inside. Well, if I bring it, I'll put it in the little hole so the popcorn actually never touches the inside of it. But they are so cool. each of the legs kind of flexes back and forth, and it looks exactly like it. Yeah, my collection of popcorn buckets is starting to get a little bit out of control. And I think it's going to get worse, only because we have a trip to Tokyo planned. And Tokyo, if you're not aware, Tokyo popcorn buckets are next level. They really are. They have some pretty awesome ones there right now. We're hoping to be there by the end of the year. We have a trip all planned and paid for. We're just waiting for Tokyo to open the borders, and Chris and I will be there, and I plan on taking a completely empty suitcase, a kind of a large one, and I'm gonna be filling it full of popcorn buckets and merch. They have the best merch. Yep, Tokyo Disneyland. They have a Disneyland, and they have Tokyo Seas. So they have two parks just like we have, and they're not across from each other. You have to take a shuttle to get to them. But Tokyo Seas is amazing. The parks are incredibly clean. You will not find a speck of popcorn or a leaf on the floor. As soon as it drops, there is somebody to pick it up. It's amazing. Yeah, there's very few popcorn buckets that I actually put the popcorn in.
That's your basketball.
Hi, Max. Yeah, I'm in LA and it's dark. Yes. Tim, is there any plans for the Magic Happens parade? No. There is, this is the only parade we have. There's cavalcades. Oh, look at Mickey and Minnie. Look at them. They are walking down the parade route. Look at this. This is the first time I've seen them do this. That's awesome. That is awesome. Yes, but Timothy, no Magic Happens parade. This is all we get. And a Frozen cavalcade or two. Yeah. We'll see what happens after summer and the MSEP parade is gone, when they pack that up. We'll see what we get. Yeah, we're really looking forward to Tokyo. We've been waiting for that trip. We've had it planned for, well, since before the pandemic hit. And unfortunately, it hit, everything was closed, plans went south, and now we're just waiting, and they're being very, very strict with their entrance of visitors and tourists into Tokyo. We hope by October time frame, things will lighten up, hopefully case numbers will be down, and we'll be able to go. And we are going to bring you guys with us. We are excited to show you Disneyland Tokyo and Disney Seas. And also Tokyo, the city. We are going to be there for quite some time. So we want to show you the city, all the amazing temples, the food. We're hoping to make a trip into Kyoto also. It's going to be a really fun trip. I cannot wait. When you eventually get there and borders open back up. Yeah, the merch that we're going to show you, it's going to blow your mind. It's going to blow your mind. The things that they come up with there, I don't know why they can't share it with the rest of the Disney parks. Because they would make a mint. Let me tell you, they would make so much money here in the park.
This one zipper is working.
Hi, Blackbeard. How are you? Thank you for joining us, everybody who's in here on our live right now, and also who have come and have gone. Thank you for joining us. We're here waiting for the parade to start.
In just a few minutes, the heart of Disneyland will light up of the Main Street Electrical Parade. Come feel the glow of this Disney classic begin in just a few minutes. Thank you.
Is it time yet? 8:38. All these folks are leaving. They're like, I need to get on the tram before the tram. Before you can't get on the tram. Yeah, the only other park that we have on the calendar to get to this year besides Tokyo is Disney World. We were there earlier this year. We did not film. It was a family trip. We did Instagram a lot of the things that we did. We had a great time. And if you're not following us on Instagram, you might wanna check us out there also. Some of the things that we do that we don't film, we do cover on our Instagram page. It is. It's just that look of old, like times past, right? It just looks like it's a historical city, and it is. I love all the lights. There's nothing like Disneyland at night.
What's wrong? What's the matter?
And it's also really great to visit at night during the summer. Chris and I are not fans of the heat, so this place during the evening is where we come during the summer nights. And they have really good food too. The desserts are the best. Almost time, guys.
The lights will be dim and the area will remain in darkness for the duration of the parade. For your safety and for those around you, please be careful if
almost time.
Thank you.
So does anyone have a favorite float from the parade? As we know from our giveaway on Sunday, we asked, I don't know if you guys can hear me with the, as we know from our giveaway question on Sunday, we gave away a Elliot popcorn bucket and 3 turtle sippers to our subscribers. We love to do giveaways. We appreciate our subscribers and our viewership. So if you're not yet subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button down below. We have giveaways coming up. We will be doing one on Saturday. We have a couple of things that we're going to be giving away. So make sure you hit that subscribe button. And when that giveaway comes up, make sure you enter. But there are 22 floats in this parade. Does anyone have a favorite? Timothy, I'll take a few minutes to get to Town Square from the Small World. yeah, this is not a fast-moving parade. And even in between, there are some pretty big breaks. They have to, so the crowds can move from one side of the street to the other. So it's gonna take a little while to get here, even when it starts. Yeah, that library lady, it was really great to have the family with us. We had a great time at Walt Disney World. We got to use their Genie Plus, and I mean, it's really helpful out here. We don't use it very much because we're here at the park all the time.
We're gonna watch a parade.
But we knew at Disney World we were gonna use the heck out of it. Because we wanted to make the most of our time and get on as many rides as we could. And that thing, it really is a lifesaver. We got on basically everything that we wanted.
You see the balloons?
Which one? Oh, you found us on Instagram. Yay! Frankie's Bride, the MSAP. It's such a beautiful parade, and my favorite, the song, it sticks in your head.
You're gonna turn off the lights.
As soon as I hear it, I turn into like a 5-year-old.
It's gonna be so dark.
I know when they did away with this parade a while back, and they said it was the last, and they were selling the light bulbs from the parade. Everybody was sad. They wanted something to take from it, so I know people who still have a light bulb from that parade. And then after many years it reappeared. I'm not mad about it. I'm glad it's back. I hope it never goes away actually. The Small World final float, the finale. Yeah, it covers everything, all the characters. I really like it. I really like it as well. I don't know if I've actually seen it from both sides. No, actually I think I have, yeah. Because I know I hadn't seen Merida on the other side, but I did this last time around.
Ready?
So we have Timothy, who loves
the
Small World Final Float.
It's so cool.
We have Ginger, who loves the Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs Float. Elliot and Pete, yeah. I like when he disappears. Ginger also loves the Small World Float. Frankie's Bride, she likes the Small World float too. Emily, you turned into a 5-year-old. Yeah, this place has a tendency to do that to people, me included. I forget about everything. All the troubles just kind of melt away.
They're not for sale. Look.
Timothy Blackbeard is always a winner. He got picked several times. He got picked twice for our giveaway. I don't know how that happened. I told Chris we need to look into a new picker. We had a couple people that were chosen a couple times. And everybody who did get chosen a couple times, you all needed to rush out and get a lottery ticket. Library lady, I grew up with MSEP, and my boys grew up with it too. So much sentimental meaning for our family. It is. It's a great parade. And I really like how they're changing it up a little bit with this new float. So it makes new memories. It's the same but different. See the balloons. I always mean to take one home, but I never do. I'm just like, I want to walk around with it in the park, but...
Yeah, we're going to watch the show.
You can't get on a ride.
Like
there's
it.
So many things you can't do once you have a balloon.
Watch.
You know what? I have no idea, but I'm going to ask. I am going to ask how much they are because I am curious to know. Is there anybody in the chat who knows how much these balloons are, the lighted balloons?
Do you want some more of your peanut butter?
Let Emily know. She wants to know how much those are.
Yeah?
Should we take a guess?
Are you sure?
What if we take a guess and the person who's who hits it or who's closest to gets a button. Gets a Walker Chronicles button.
He's got a nice warm jacket on and he's not standing.
Oh, yeah, Timothy says $15. Timothy, is that a fact or is that a guess?
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's
you gotta appreciate it.
After an hour and a half, 2 hours.
Let us know.
You better.
I am dying to know.
No bad.
That's a guess. That's a pretty good guess. Being that they don't, they're not like the balloons that I grew up with, the big Mickey ears. And those ones, as soon as you touch something sharp, they would pop. These ones don't do that. These ones have a plastic coating around it. And I'm pretty sure they don't, you won't find them on the floor the next day. I know, the different colors for the seasons and the different prints too.
I know. Do you want
snacks?
You'll find, I'm looking at one and I think I can see Toy Story. It's a Pixar balloon. And then if I look to the far side over here, I know it looks pretty far, but from what I can tell, they look like a bunch of, it looks like maybe the Fab Five characters over there. So all depending on which ones you want. And then there's another bunch of clusters over there. They are all over this place. Now, when we were in Paris, and they've done the same thing in Tokyo also, and I know they used to do it here. They don't do it anymore because of the whole, you know, world bug thing that's happening. They used to let you hold on to the whole bunch and take a picture, like you were selling them or you had bought them all. They don't let you do that anymore here, but in Paris, they still let you do that. And in Tokyo, before everything shut down, they were allowing you to do that too. I don't know if they still do, but once we get there, I have a picture of myself holding the bunch of balloons in Tokyo. I hope that they'll continue to do that because that was a lot of fun. The lady who was selling them hid behind me. She kind of crouched down behind me. It was funny.
You wanna do it again?
I thought you wanted to go home.
Let's see what is going on. So we have 24 people in the chat. Hope everyone is having a good evening. Hopefully your work week is going well. And hopefully we'll see you guys here in the park. And if not, we'll see you here on some live streams.
Hey, stop.
Not sure what we're gonna do for the 28th. I know we're gonna be filming a video. Do you guys wanna see a live stream of Fantasmic?
Do you hear the music go off? Let me go see if it's coming.
Work would be better. But park live streams always make my day better. Oh, we're glad. We're glad that these live streams can bring a little bit of lightness to your day. Life can get heavy. Life can get heavy, so coming here to the park and sharing these things with you makes our day. Yeah, Chris and I were talking about live streams, and I know there's been a request for more live streams from us. We don't live far, so we're lucky in that sense. Chris and I had talked a while back also about doing like a Mickey Mornings live stream. This was before reservations became really difficult to get. I mean, if I can grab a reservation every day, I would be more than happy to walk the park every day and show you what's going on. I don't know if that's something you guys would be interested in, but if it is, let us know. Like I said, we don't live far from the park, and as long as we can grab a reservation, at least one of us can grab a reservation, we'll be more than happy to do a daily live stream if that's what you guys would be interested in. So we have, oh my God, please. I'm guessing that's for Fantasmic. We have Timothy saying yes, Library Lady yes. I know, and Emily me. Two cents, we can't be there. Yeah, the plan was to do Mickey Mornings, like before we realized that reservations, even for Dream Key holders, would be difficult to obtain. We thought, well, we could do Mickey Mornings and Knott's Nights, because we're not far from Knott's Berry Farm either. So Knott's Nights, Mickey Mornings, the only problem with Knott's is that they close early. I don't know why. They have their times where they close it during the weekdays at 10, but most of the time during the off season they close at 6, so it's not even dark then. So not mid-afternoon, I don't know what we'd call it. Timothy, I could use a large Mickey Mouse chocolate, what is it, chocolate bar right now. I know, Mickey Mornings does sound fun. Oh, I hear music. I hear music. Yeah, maybe Mickey Mornings are still in the cards. Like I said, as long as we can get a reservation, and especially during summer, it would be really nice to do visits to the park in the mornings because it wouldn't be that hot. So, yeah, maybe that's something that that we'll do for you guys. I think it would be fun. They are clearing the streets.
See? They blocked off the road. See? They're blocking it off. So no one can do it.
They're gonna turn off the lights in just a minute.
Sorry.
Once that balloon cart goes, we know we're in business. They're not gonna miss the opportunity to sell a $15 balloon, I don't think.
Oh, do you want to stand up?
Yeah, Downtown Disney. On mornings that I can't get a reservation, I would love a peek into the world of color, for example. Yeah, definitely. We've never really focused on merch. We know there's a lot of other channels that do that. They're not here in the park every day. But yeah, we would be more than happy to go into World of Color, check out what's here in the Emporium and in the shopping areas here on Main Street, and then even do a park hop at 1 o'clock over to DCA and see what they have. So if the park opens at 8, 9 o'clock, it would be a pretty long live stream to get to DCA. Maybe we could do DCA and then Downtown Disney, a double D. Mickey mornings, yes. Get some Mickey shaped waffles.
Oh, I see the.
Yeah, it's kind of sad that Knott's closes so early. The hours are going to be changing soon. Especially for summer, they will be staying open later, and that's great. That's kind of the time that Chris and I were thinking about Knott's Nights, because they were staying open later. So for summer, yeah, I think for summer we might just do Mickey mornings and Knott's Nights. See how it goes. See if you guys and what the viewership is. And if there's more interest, we'll keep doing it.
Can you see the stroller?
We have yet to go to Knott's for their official summer season. They just opened it. We hope to get there this weekend. So we'll be here Saturday for Fantasmic. It's going to kind of be a theme park weekend. We also have plans to go to here we go. Thank you, Emily. We'd appreciate the share.
50 years ago, a magical girl sparkled the light, bringing wonder and joy to the young and the young heart. Alive with imagination, it continues to grow, welcoming new friends and stories, inspiring new generations, and shining into our hearts with its heritage and hope. For its magic celebrates togetherness, and the spirit of Walt Disney's words that welcome the world. To all the mountainous peoples,
I love this part. I love that part. To all who come to this happy place, melts my heart. The music. Yeah, how can this keep your head from bobbing? My head is bobbing, my rear is bobbing up and down. Ha 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 ha. No, there are no fireworks tonight. Those are only on the weekend. Unfortunately. And they do have projections from Mickey's Mixed Magic. I know, Emily, doesn't it? It just makes you smile. Here it comes.
I'm not going to be able to do that. To see her. She's in
Gets old. The song, the floats, the just everything. I could watch that all day, every day. I am gonna call it a night. We've been on the stream for 3 hours and 20 minutes according to the clock. I've had a wonderful time spending the day here with you, showing you the park. We got on a couple rides, finishing it off with this amazing parade. I want to thank each and every one of you for joining me tonight. I've had a blast with you all, and I hope we can do it again soon. So we talked about Mickey mornings and not nights, so I will talk to Chris on that, and we'll make it happen and see how it goes. If we get a lot of interest, then we'll keep it going, and if not, then we will phase it out and move on to something else. But I want to thank you all for joining me tonight. I really appreciate your company, and I hope to see you all very, very soon. I'll see you guys on the next episode of The Walker Chronicles. Bye, guys. Oh, wait, wait, wait. No projections. No, we're calling. Oh, Hunter. okay. I need to know who wants me to stay for the projections. If I get more than just one person, I will stay for the projections. But if not, I'm gonna call it a night. I'm still resting my throat. So I need to know from you guys, how many of you guys want to see the projections? I think, I'm not even sure what time they start. Let me take a look. I'm not really sure. Oh, hi Team Boy Boy Vlog from Milipas, California. It's nice to have you. We're rounding out our night here. I'm not sure if we're gonna stay for the projections. Not unless we take a vote and the yays have it and the nays don't. So let me know. Good night, Library Lady. Thank you for joining us. We hope to see you again soon. We have, so far it just looks like Hunter, Frankie Bees, Brian, good night. I think we're calling it, guys. Sorry. We will be here again. I know. It starts in 5 minutes. Rest that throat and go have some tea. I know, it's like, it's on fire right now. Okay. If it truly starts in 5 minutes, then we're good. But if it doesn't, then I'm gonna have to call it a night. So let's go down back to Main Street. I guess we're gonna keep this going at least for the meantime. Let's go down to Main Street. Hopefully these projections start in 5 minutes, because if not, I'm gonna be calling it a night. I feel like I'm already losing my voice.
Okay.
We'll go down. We'll try the projections. If I can even find a spot. It looks like people are already crowding in around there. The projections are going to be for Mickey's Mixed Magic. So it's nothing new. It's not anything you probably haven't seen before. Let's give it a shot. I'm gonna need the biggest cup of tea in history to take care of this throat. Let's go do this. And then I'm gonna go wrap myself in a big hot blanket when I get home. I may actually lose my voice after this one. I'm not really sure. Oh, it's getting very faint. Okay, I'm gonna turn you guys around so you can see the crowd coming out. Yeah, I'm not really sure how all this is gonna get cleared up in 5 minutes, but I will give you 5 minutes and see if these projections actually start. Let's get over to the curb to avoid all the oncoming traffic.
Good evening, friends. In just a few minutes, the lights will be dim, so you may fully experience our nighttime spectacular. For your own safety and the safety of those around you, please remain
okay, Hunter,
until the lights return to normal. Thank you.
Hunter, you win.
Buenas noches, amigos. En tan solo unos minutos, las luces se atenuarán para que puedan disfrutar plenamente de nuestro gran espectáculo nocturno. Por su seguridad y la seguridad de quienes
So we still have 20 people in the chat.
Hasta que las luces sean restauradas. Gracias.
Who I hope will be staying around for the projections of Mickey's Mixed Magic. So we are going to go just a little bit ahead of the Penny Arcade. because we want to see as much of the projections as we can, and this is usually a pretty good spot. So let's hang out over here on Alright, we are in front of the Penny Arcade. Yeah, I guess we have just a few more minutes before the show starts, and then we can actually be in the center of Main Street. So I'm curious to know how many people in the chat have not yet seen Mickey's Mixed Magic. Yeah, Keith, there are no fireworks. There are no fireworks during the week, only on the weekends. So today's show is going to just be the projections of Mickey's Mixed Magic here on the buildings and also on the castle. But unfortunately there are no fireworks. Let me get in the middle of the street. Here we go. Sorry, but I have a tendency to sing through this.
You're ready to party, won't be late. Let's get it started, cause we just can't wait, can't wait.
Hey! those vibey haunts have received your sympathetic vibrations and are beginning to materialize. They're assembling for a swing, wing, wing. No flash pictures. Please, I want those creepy little songs quick. Not the swing, wing. Happy haunts materialize. And we enter all the life, bring us out to socialize. Don't try to hide. Promise it at least to fix it by your side. Shroud in your brandish hide. They pretend to paralyze. Bring us out to socialize. Nine times higher than a tree. Jump out to the midnight street. To live in green sweet. Life to sweet, not a life. Bring us out to socialize.
Yeah.
Gracias por habernos acompañado durante Mickey's Mix Magic. Que sigan disfrutando su mágica visita aquí en el lugar.
Okay, Hunter. Hunter, that was for you. But I'm tapping out. No mas, no mas. I need to, I need to get, let me find a spot here. Yeah. Call it in a night. I need to get myself the biggest cup of hot tea ever. My throat is on fire. But was it worth it? Yeah, that Mickey's Mix Magic is always a good time. People dancing in the street. You have snow, all the characters. I love it. But again, thank you guys for joining me on this live stream. I did enjoy, I always enjoy it. I always sing along and I always dance to the music for Mickey's Mix Magic. This particular show, whether it has fireworks or not, it's a dance party. So I always enjoy this stuff. So yes, thank you. Oh, thank you, Hunter. I know. I'm nursing a cold and a very, very sore throat. So I'm probably gonna get a hot tea. Good night, Trisha. Good night, and thank you again. Thank you again for your support of the channel. I really appreciate it. I'm probably gonna get the biggest cup of hot tea, or at least hot water with lemon, if I can get it from Starbucks here. But thank you everybody for joining us. I appreciate your support and joining us for these live streams. We had a lot of fun here today. Peter G, it's well worth it. Get some rest. Yeah. I'm gonna curl up under some very hot blankets and take a lot of throat lozenges to try to calm this down. But thanks again, guys, and we will see you on the next episode of the Walker Chronicles. Bye, guys. Bye.